Making a silver dice. What a simple project, right? Well, not in my case. But I can promise you that there will be a necessary amount of silver casting to different methods of silver purification. And also some good old machining. So, sit down, relax, and please enjoy. The very idea of making a silver dice was sitting in my mind for a quite long time. To be honest, I bought the silver probably 2 years ago and it was just sitting in my drawer ever since. But now is the time to finally bring it to life. I've started the project by machining graphite mold. It always gets me how easy is graphite machinable. It is literally like cutting a butter with knife. As you can see, the mold turned just perfect. The mold is ready. Time to fill the crucible. It's not a pure silver, so you can see impurities floating on the surface. And this was my first attempt on smelting silver, and I can say that the result looks quite good. I also did a little bit of hammering to bring it very close to cube-like shape. And now it's time to reveal that hidden cube inside the material by machining. After all the machining, I finally got a decent looking cube, but I consider it too small and there was also a lot of waste left behind. That's also why I machined new and bigger mold, again out of graphite. Little did I know that this project will turn into the very definition of insanity. I recasted the cube so many times expecting different outcome, but it was just terrible. I also left the silver solidifying in the foundry, but it wasn't any better. I realized that the issue might be silver composition. All the impurities oxidizing in contact with atmospheric oxygen causing troubles. That's why I sent the alloy for analysis, and as you can see, there's a lot of copper. Which means it's time for silver purification. So I broke it into manageable pieces and I used nitric acid to dissolve it. The final step was silver precipitation by copper wire. It's an instant reaction, like a magic in front of your eyes. And just like every new Batman movie, the solution turned darker and darker. All the gray sediment at the very bottom is a silver powder, and after multiple rinsing with hot water and final filtration, it looks like this. I got new set of analytical data, and first of all, I lost 10% of silver in the process. Also, there is still 3.6% of impurities. Well,
3.6, not great, not terrible.
Exactly, but I think I can do better. So I casted silver pellets again, this time more successfully, and into nitric acid it goes. However, this time I use different method. Hydrochloric acid to get silver chloride, which I turned in silver oxide using household lye. And finally, I added sugar to reduce oxide into silver metal, which is all the fluffy stuff you see. I lost only 1.8% of silver using lye sugar method, and the final composition is very close to 3.9, but there is still 0.2% of impurities present. And for better understanding, visualization on 10 grams of alloy. With this being the starting point, the precipitation by copper led to this composition. And finally, the composition after sugar and lye method. And as you can see, beside the purified silver, I also bought pure silver shot, because I simply realized I want even bigger dice, precisely at least 1 inch large. It also means that another remilling of the mold was inevitable. This was by far the best attempt, but you can still see some impurities floating on the surface. It looks really good. Note the shining surface, finally. I was able to remove shallow voids by off-camera hammering. And finally the milling. After milling all the sides, I continued with digits. Now was time to clean the surface by a mirror cloth. And after all the issues, let me present you 1-inch silver dies. Ultimate question, does it work? Yes, and you get 6 every single time. Nah, just kidding. Only if you're behind the editing software. It's almost shame to destroy it, but I promised. By the way, this is the final composition, achieved by mixing 2 different sources of silver. Not gonna lie you, it was hard for me to watch. It also reminds me the first time seeing this iconic scene. But in this case it's constructive destruction. And I also use it as an excuse to try out petrobone sand. And now I need to stretch it to 12 centimeters. So much for hammering, and now it's time for final machining. So I turned 1 big dice into 10 small ones. But why? Well, my YouTube journey was sometimes sunny and funny, bumpy and muddy. Other times it was just raw or completely weird. And there were even moments when it was like this. but I finally arrived at the start line by reaching 1000 subscribers, and I'd like to thank you for that. And at this moment I realized it would be cool to set a system of milestones, and for every 1000 of subscribers it takes home up to 10k, release some kind of token. Well, in this case, silver dice. Thank you so much for watching, and if you want to claim the first dice, see the description for more information. Till next time, guys.